Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, have your way, yeah, in this place. Truly Israel, yeah. It has been a wonderful time that we have had during this celebration. And a wonderful time of you being here with us to join us in this celebration. Because it's all about Yah. And we have heard the great and wonderful word of Yah's truth in his Torah about his Emunah, Yisrael Yah, and how he would see his people through. Let me read just a little bit in Yaakov, James 5 and 11. It said, behold, we count them happy which endure, Yisrael Yah. For you have heard the patience of our brother Job and knew what he had went through, but still his trust was in Abba Yahweh. He seen him until the end in his affliction. And then it says on, goes on to say, and have seen the end of the purpose of Yahweh. Hand at work, Israel, Yah. That Yahweh is very, very pitiful toward his people. And not only that, Israel, Yah, but it is a harbor. Stand firm, Israel, Yah. But it goes on to tell us, Israel, Yah, a little further on down in Matthew 24 and 13. But only can we stand, Israel, Yah, and only can we get the victory. But he that shall endure, Israel, Yah, let us stand steadfast, Israel, Yah, believing in what the ox and the Zacchaeus told us during this feast. It said, endure until the end. And not only till the end, but he said, those that endure to the end shall be delivered, Israel, Yah, by his precious Emunah in Yahshua HaMashiach, Israel, Yah. Let us stand firm, Israel, Yah. Trust in Israel, Yah, of the Torah that was spoken to us. Let us zakah, let us remember Israel, Yah. Until the next time we meet Israel, Yah, keep the Torah firm within your lives, Israel, Yah. Let it not depart from you, Israel, Yah. That you stand, Israel, Yah, because we have a battle ahead, Israel, Yah. And as each ox spoke, Israel, Yah, they told us that Yah have gave us the tools to endure, Israel, Yah. And we can stand firm, Israel, Yah, stressing in Yahshua, the Emunah, that Yah has put in us to make us a precious people unto him, a segula, a special people, a set apart people that's different from this world, Israel, Yah. Don't let anybody tell you any different, Israel, Yah. But stand, Israel, Yah, and declare Yah's truth, Israel, Yah, as being a child of the King, a great King, for there is none like thee. And all the Olam and all the Hashemayim, Israel, Yah, that whatever you're going through, that you can endure it. Because we had so many examples in the Torah that showed us how Yah came to their rescue, Israel, Yah. So stand firm, Israel, Yah, knowing that some still will be here with a little while longer. But on your journey back, take of what was spoken during the feast back with you, Israel, Yah, that it keep you in your battles, no matter what it may be, or whatever the opposition may be that come against you, Israel, Yah, still trust in Yah's Torah, and you will get the victory, Israel, Yah, and you will prevail, because Yah cannot lie, and his word is truth, Israel, Yah. So what we do, Israel, Yah, we just stand still and see Yah's Yashak work, Israel, Yah, because of him who fights our battle, but not ourselves, Israel, Yah. For this is a spiritual battle that we've been doing. So we leave it unto Yah. We call upon Yah or whatever it may be, Israel, that we have to go through, that we can endure it. Because he will come to our rescue. All we have to do is just call on him, Israel. Our sincere love, Israel. And he will be there. Because it said in Kephah, 1 Peter 4 and 12, beloved, think it not strange concerning these fiery trials, which is to try you, as though some strange thing had happened to us, Israel. It says, go on, it says, Peter 4 and 13, but rejoice in as much as you've been partakers of Yah's precious Son, Yahshua HaMashiach, and the suffering that he went through, Israel. Let us rejoice that he has made us a partaker of that, Israel. For knowing that he has shown his ahava, his great ahava, toward us, Israel. That when his honor shall be revealed, that you may be glad. Not only glad, Israel, also with exceedingly joy, Israel, knowing that you are made a part of his inheritance, Israel. Ain't you glad you came to the feast, Israel? Because it has been a wonderful time, Israel. And Yah has truly baraked us during this feast, Israel. His Torah has went forth to strengthen Israel, to let us know that we can go through the battle, that we can endure. And for us to lift up our heads and stand strong in who? In the might and strength of Yahshua HaMashiach, Israel. That came, Yeromiah, Israel.
Shalom, Israel. May the blessings of Yahweh rest upon you all on this eve. As our Zaken expressed unto us, as we start to bring this feast of Sukkot to a close, I somewhat, in a way, desire that it could go a little longer. In the sense that we know there are you that have came to be with us. We have to see you depart, see you go back to your places, to your homes, take care of your business. But let us not forget the experience that we share together on every feast. The Torah, the mitzvah that's being preached, the fellowship, the words of wisdom that come from each ach, that we will look forward to and desire to come again to the next feast that, as I preached a few days ago, that we should return, Israel. And as we go, as we leave this place, let us leave anew and refreshed. Let us go back with something when we go home. You know, there's nothing worse than going to a place, whether it's a store, whether it is an event, and your expectations at that place have not been met, and you go back home empty without nothing. Man, it wasn't worth going. I wasted my time. This is not a waste of time. This is what Yahweh desires. So let us take an abundance of wisdom back home with us and apply it. Let us not come to the feast and we hear the wonderful words of Yahweh being spoken, or what you hear via live stream, or what you hear from each ah and each aho, and let it go to the wayside, Israel. The Torah said that the words of Yahweh went forth, did it not? Did it return unto him void? So when we return unto the feast, we should be able to bring fruit, should we not, Israel? And there will be labor expressed, it will be visual. We will know that when we left, we came back with more. That as Yahshua and Almighty Yahweh gives us the token, his mitzvah, his word, we will show as tough servants. We will go out and we will allow that to multiply, that we can bring back unto Almighty Yahweh an abundance of praise and todah. That we have something to offer back unto Almighty Yahweh. It reminds me of that parable that he spoke of the ruler. He was a great king. He was one to be feared. And he left talents to his servants. But yet when he come back, there was a wicked one. And he said he was wicked. And he was cast into the lowest parts of Sheol, of hell. Why? Because he took that talent and that gift that Yah gave him and he hid it in the earth. So let us not hide it, Israel. Let us not be ashamed of Almighty Yahweh. But let us allow the Zerah, the Torah, the seed to be planted in our lives, that we produce and more abundance of fruit, Israel. What I want to do tonight, our king that have spake or have spoken throughout this feast, Azar King Benjamin, Yowasada, Yoshibi, and Shimri, they're going to come up again before us and have a few more words, since this is some of the last gathering we should have here. But yet we should gather, Yisrael. For this begins the Shabbaton, and we'll keep the Shabbaton on to tomorrow. Hallelujah. But they're going to recap. They're going to remind us. They're going to give us more words of encouragement each up. And then I will come up. We will close this service tonight. But I do want to read this here in Tehillim before I ask our king to come up in that order. It says here in Tehillim chapter 85, Psalms 85. I want to read this chapter because there's one verse I want to get to here. It says that Yahweh, thou hast been favorable unto your land, your riches, your possession, your people. He said, thou hast brought back the captivity of Jacob, and you have forgiven the iniquity of your people. Yahweh has forgiven the iniquity of Israel. But we must continue to walk according to his statutes, Israel, his commandments. Forgiveness comes when we repent, and that of a pure lev, a lev that does not desire or want to go back to those things, the sin, wherever we have gone, anything you may have done before you came. Let us not go back, Israel, and continue in those things. He said he has forgiven the iniquity of Israel, thy people, and you have covered all of their sin. Have not the Dama Yahshua covered all of our sin, Israel? Is not Yahshua our Pesach? Does not his dam wash away all those things that our garment may be presented unto Almighty Yahweh white as snow? As some people would say, a clean slate. We start over. We are renewed. We are washed. We are made clean. We do not talk the same way. We're not going to walk the same way. We should not act the same way. But we should act according to what Torah speaks. Let me read on. He said, you have covered all of their sins, Salah, and thou hast taken away your wrath. He said, you have taken away cold, all of your wrath. If not Yahweh angry, isn't that anger with the wicked every day? He's angry with the wicked every day. Don't let no one fool you. They want to say, oh, he does not hate the sinner. He hates the sin. No, he hates the sinner. He hates the man. He hates the one that does not walk after and according to his mitzvah, his Torah. He said, thou hast taken away thy wrath, and you have turned yourself from the fierceness of your anger. I told you, he has turned himself from the fierceness of his anger because he has every right, Israel, to be angry with us. Why? We present ourselves wicked unto him continuously. We just be honest with ourselves. We find ourselves falling short. We find ourselves in the midst of trials. We kind of want to fudge things a little bit. We try to adjust things a little bit instead of allowing that trial, that circumstance, to have its perfect way. He said, you have turned thyself from the fierceness of thy anger. He says unto Yahweh, that we says unto Yahweh, thus turn us, O Yahweh, of our Yashuk, of our salvation. He's saying, turn unto us, Almighty Yahweh, and cause thy anger towards us to cease. So you must understand that we were severely judged for his iniquity and his sins. So he's asking for the hasid and the continual hasid, the ahava, the love of Almighty Yahweh. He asked this question in verse 5. Will thou be angry with us forever? Do we want Yahweh to be angered with us forever, Israel? Then we must choose. We must turn from our sins. We must turn from our evil, wicked ways and our pernicious ways, Israel. He asks, will you be angry with us forever? And wilt thou draw out thy anger to all generations? He said, will you draw it out? Will you allow your judgment to go upon my child and their children's children? Did he not say he will curse those from generation to generation, Israel, that hate Almighty Yahweh? And he asked this humbly, wilt thou receive us again? He said, will you receive us? Will you allow us to come into your presence of Ahava, your presence of love? He said, that thy people may rejoice in thee. He said, will you do that, Almighty Yahweh? He said, show us your hasid, O Almighty Yahweh, and grant unto us your Yashak. He has granted us his Yashak and Yahshua HaMashiach. Verse 8. He said, I will hear what Yahweh, our Abba, will speak. Will we hear what Yahweh speak tonight? Through the voices of our King? Will we obey and do as Yahweh commands us, Yisrael? He said, I will hear what Yahweh shall speak, for he will speak shalom. Our King will speak shalom unto us, Yisrael. He will speak shalom unto his people and to his saints, his kedushas. But let them not turn unto folly. So Yahweh, he forgives us. He has washed us from our iniquity and our sins. He has allowed us to once again come into his presence, Yisrael. I don't know if you understand how important that is. Because if he does not receive us into his presence, then we are cast into Sheol. We are cast into hell. That's what David is speaking. He said, do not remove your Kodesh Ruach from me, Almighty Yahweh. But knowing that Yahweh has done this for us, Yisrael, we have the knowledge, we have wisdom and understanding that he has done this. Let us not return unto folly. Let us not go back to our old ways. Let us not go back unto sin. Let us not be a hypocrite, Yisrael, but let us be for real. Let us be real and continue to tolerate Yahweh for all things. We must take these things to heart because this is our life. This is how we live. Whether you want to believe that or not, whether your mind fights against that, there's only one way to live, and that is by his mishvu, his mishvah. So he said, don't return unto folly. So even as we leave this place, we go back to our homes. You go back to Texas or wherever you come from. Yisrael, let us not return unto folly. Let us forever keep his mishvah and his Torah on our levim, on our minds, and on our hearts. So at this time, I'm going to ask our Zakein. He has spoken unto us once, but I want to ask him just to leave some more words of encouragement with this experience, Yisrael, for us this night. Hallelujah. Zakein Benjamin Abash.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. As I came, Yeromiah was telling us to let us not to go back to the folly. It said in Yokohan John, as for you, let that there stay in you which you have heard from the beginning, and we have heard a great and wonderful word spoken to us by the Akim and the Zakein, this feast, Yisrael. Let us not take that on deaf ears. And then it goes on to tell us, if that which you have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, you shall also continue as the Son Yahshua HaMashiach, and not only as the Son, as his Father, Abba Yahweh Yisrael. And in this Yisrael, 1 John 2 and 25, and this is the promise that he has promised us, even eternal life, Yisrael. But Yisrael, not only Yisrael, as of us hearing the word Yisrael, it goes on to tell us in James, Yisrael, as Romeo was telling us when we go back, he said, but be doers of the word, not only his, Yisrael, deceiving your own selves, Yisrael. Let us take heed to what them Akim spoke to us during the feast, Israel, y'all. For any be a hearer of the word, not a doer, he'll like unto a man, and we have heard, beholding his natural face in a glass. For behold himself goes his way. Straightway forgets what manner of man he was. But let us, I call, remember of the word that was spoken during this feast, Israel, that as we go away, Israel, that we go away with strength, ready to fight this battle, Israel, ready to stand for Yah. James 1 and 25, but whoso looketh into that perfect Torah of liberty, Torah Yah, and continue therein, Israel, he being not a forgetful here, but a doer of the work of Israel, for knowing that where his strength come from, this man shall he barak in his deeds, Israel. Once again, let us take heed to the word that was spoken, Israel, to us during this feast, Israel, for it is for our strength, Israel. It goes on a little farther. In Timothy, our brother Timothy tells us, because when you leave Israel, you're going to be confronted with High Satan. And it tells us, but evil men and seducers shall work worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But you, Israel, in Timothy 3 and 14, it said, but continue in the things which you have heard during this feast, and that you have learned of what the ox have spoken, with a true and pure heart of Abba Yahweh, Israel. It said, continue, and has been assured of the word that was spoken out of their mouth during the feast, knowing of whom you have learned them from of Abba Yahweh, of the word that was spoken from his Torah, Israel. 2 Timothy 3 and 15 tells us, and that from a child you have known the Kekfei and the Hakadosh, which are able, Israel, we take heed to this Torah, Israel, and the word that was spoken, which are able to make you wise to Yahshak, Yah's Torah, through the Emunah, Israel, which is in Yahshua HaMashiach, Israel. No other way, Israel, can we endure this race, Israel, without trusting and Yahshua HaMashiach and the Emunah. Because it said in Timothy 3 and 16, all scriptures are given by the inspiration of Abba Yahweh, and it's profitable for what we have heard during this feast, for the doctrine, Torah Yah, for the reproof, what we have heard, for the correction, and for the instruction of his Tzedekah, Israel. And told y'all for that, that the man, in Timothy 3 and 17 tells us, of Yahweh may be made perfect, Israel, of his precious son, thoroughly furnished, prepared, Israel, equipped to go through the battle. To all, Israel, call all his tub misfox, Israel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Israel, Yah is so tough to us. Then he goes on to tell us, till I come, in Timothy 4 and 13, give attendance to reading and to the exhortation of Yah's doctrine, Yisrael Yah. To Yah's Torah that was spoken, Yisrael Yah. Let us take heed that we be strong, Yisrael Yah. That we do not bow down to the enemy, Yisrael Yah. Because, Yisrael Yah, we have the tools. Yah's Torah is all we need. And all we have to do is just endure, Yisrael Yah. Endure this race until the end, Yisrael Yah. That we may be able to stand in these last and evil days. It says in Timothy 4 and 15, it said, meditate upon these things that were given to us during the feast, Yisrael Yah, to strengthen the life of his people. Because it is profitable to us, Yisrael Yah, that Yah's emunah may appear to all that believe, Yisrael Yah. So let us take heed, Yisrael Yah, to yourself and the doctrine, Yisrael Yah, and continue in them for the doing, Yisrael Yah. You shall both deliver yourself, Yisrael Yah, and them that hear you, Yisrael Yah. And those that spoke to us, Yisrael Yah, and would speak a word to us, Yisrael Yah, out through the night, Yisrael Yah. Yes. Let us hear them, Yisrael Yah, yes. That we endure this race until the end. Hallelujah. Let us not reject, Yisrael Yah, of what Yah is showing us, yes. Of what's in us, Yisrael Yah. Hallelujah. And showing us of where we need to come up, Yisrael Yah. The Yisrael Yah, we may endure until the end. Hallelujah. To see and to look upon Yahshua HaMashiach's face, Yisrael Yah. Don't you want to see that day, Yisrael Yah? Yes. Because, Yisrael Yah, we can make it through. Don't get weary, Yisrael Yah. Don't faint, Yisrael Yah. Just stand still, Yisrael Yah, and see the Yashak of Yah's truth, Yisrael Yah. Because it said in Ezra, is Yahweh not great that makes all things, Yisrael Yah? Therefore, great is the truth. And stronger than all things, Yisrael Yah. For all the earth cries upon his truth. And the Hashemayim blesses it, Yisrael Yah. So should us, Yisrael Yah, when Yah's truth is spoken to us, Yisrael Yah. Our work shake and tremble at it. With the truth is no unrighteous thing, Yisrael Yah. Wine is wicked. The king is wicked. Women are wicked. Yes. All the children of men are wicked. Yes. But such are all their wicked works. There is no truth in them. But in the unrighteous, yes, also they shall perish, Yisrael Yah. But as for the truth, yes, and those that endure, Yisrael Yah, total you, it is always strong, Yisrael Yah. Not only is it always strong, Yisrael Yah, it lives, Yisrael Yah, and it conquers, Yisrael Yah, all obstacles, all opposition, whatever you have to go, Yisrael Yah. Not only do it conquer, Yisrael Yah, But it says forevermore, Yisrael Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Take heed, Yisrael Yah, to Yah's Torah. Let it enter into our land. Let it lead us and guide us, Yisrael Yah. Let it direct our paths, Yisrael Yah. Not only let it direct our paths in every situation, Yisrael Yah. Let Yah's Torah, Yisrael Yah. Whatever you come against, go to Yah's Torah to get the victory, Yisrael Yah. For this battle, we cannot fight on our own, because we cannot get the victory. But through Yahshua HaMashiach, we can win every time, because we know that he's one that never loses a battle. We know that he's one that created the enemy that we're fighting against, Yisrael Yah. So let us trust in Yah's Torah. And it's great celebration. Even though the end has come, the end has not come. Because the truth and the word that was spoken to us, let it keep us always, Yisrael Yah. Not only always, but from day to day, and morning until night, Yisrael Yah. Because Yisrael Yah, we're truly in a battle. And it ain't got heated up yet. And the brothers told us, as long as we trust in Yahshua HaMashiach Emunah, we can go through that battle too. Well, we be put in the fire. If we speak like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, he'll deliver us too. Yisrael Yah, stand still. And once again, Yisrael Yah, we have truly enjoyed y'all during this feast, Yisrael Yah. Because during this feast, Yisrael Yah, we are one that take it serious. And will continue to do what Yah have commanded us to do. We will honor his feast each and every feast. We will praise his name. Because we know that we have a great and mighty king. That truly Ahava his people. He have commanded us to do it, and we will do it, Yisrael Yah. And we told you that he made a way. And it's not just by coincidence that you're here, Yisrael Yah, to be with us during this great and congregation and feast, Yisrael Yah. I told you, Yisrael Yah, and told you each ox as they spoke this feast to strengthen us, Yisrael Yah, and to let us know, Yisrael Yah, of our shortcomings and our lack of what we have toward Abba Yahweh and what we have to do to get it right in the space of time that he gave us, Yisrael Yah. Abba Rock Yah, in Yahshua HaMashiach's name, Yisrael Yah. Akiwasadat, come forth.
I call us the Kedushim's of Yah because we are Yah's people, his elect ones. I like to start off in 1 Corinthians 1 and 9. Yahweh is faithful, by whom you were called to the fellowship of his son, Yahshua HaMashiach, our Messiah, our Master. The theme of this thing is the Emunah and the faithfulness of Yah, and what we should have, our faithfulness and our dedication should be towards Yah. Revelations 19 and 11. And I saw the Shemayim open, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat upon him was called Faithful. Now, he was called Faithful. So we should have faith in the one that is called Faithful. Our Emunah should be in the one that is called Faithful. And faithful, the meaning of faithful is, it says, full of emunah, ready to believe, especially in the declaration and promises of Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
So we should be ready to trust full-hearted, full-fledged in what Yah has promised unto us. Called faithful and true, and in righteousness he does judge and make war. Wisdom 3:1. But the nephesh of the righteous is in the hand of Yahweh.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
It, all our nephishes, Yahweh is holding in his hand.
Yes.
When we're in Yahweh's hand, there is nothing that can harm us, that can touch us. There's safety, there's shelter in Yah's hand.
Yes,
and the rest of the scripture says, no torment shall touch them. We're free from torment.
Yes.
Wisdom 3:2, it says, in the sight of the unwise, they seem to die. But we know in Yahweh, we rest, we sleep, we don't die. We have a tikvah. And their departure is taken for misery. And the reason it being is because they don't have no hope. We have hope. So it's not misery to us. We're going to see our maker. Wisdom 3:3. And they're going from us to be utter destruction, but they are in shalom. We are in shalom because Yahweh is the giver of shalom.
Yes.
He gives peace.
Yes.
He gives tikvah.
Yes.
Wisdom 3:4. For though they be punished in the sight of men, yet is their tikvah full of immortality. Our hope is everlasting.
Yes.
It's continual.
Hallelujah.
It goes on and on,
yes,
from generation to generation.
Hallelujah.
Wisdom 3:5. And having been a little chastised,
yes,
now we are going to get, we are going to be chastised. We're going to be proven that we're counted worthy,
yes,
that we may enter into his presence with thanksgiving, understanding why we're granted these such great gifts, why Yahweh has bestowed these things on us. They shall be greatly rewarded. And why should we be greatly rewarded? Because we have proven ourselves. We have suffered for the name of Yahweh. We have not let anything circumvent us from those things that we are pressing toward. Wrote it greatly, for Yahweh proved them. And not only did he prove them, he found them worthy for himself.
Hallelujah.
He found us when Yahshua was on the stake. Yahweh looked down and said, behold, my beloved son, who I am well pleased. Yahweh chastised him for our sake. But he still looked down and said, he's worthy. He's worthy unto me. As gold in the furnace, he has tried them. Now, it says, as gold in the furnace, he has tried them. Yahweh is going to try us. It don't matter what we think, what we say. We're gonna be, what we say is we're gonna have to prove that.
That's right.
We're gonna have to show that what we mean, as they say, the rubber's gonna meet the road.
Right.
Okay. Wisdom 3:7, and in the time of their visitation, they shall shine. Now that word visitation, let's look at that definition real quick. An official visit of a superior. Yahweh is our superior being. He is our Abba.
Yes,
so we are visited by our Abba. He comes and dwells with us. And they shall shine. Now, when Yahweh dwells in us, we should be like a city that sit upon a hill, that light that cannot be hid. Because we are radiating Yahweh's Torah, his truth, his mitzvah. And run to and fro like sparks among the stubble. And Jeremiah said, his word is like fire shut up in my bone.
Yes.
Wisdom 3 and 8. And they shall judge the nations and have dominion over the people. And Yahweh shall reign. And Yahweh shall reign them forever.
Yes.
And in my last verse, Wisdom 3 and 9. They that put their trust in him shall understand the truth, and such as be faithful in Ahava shall abide in him. For free unmerited pardon Ahava and kindness in his condition, and he watches and cares for his elect. So Yahweh cares for his people. He cares for his sheep. Yahweh will not let anything happen to his people. So shalom to all you Kedushim of Yah. We pray that Yahweh has baraked all of you. We enjoyed your presence. And that may Yahweh give you a safe passage on your way home. At Yeshibia.
Hallelujah. For truly I have enjoyed the feast of Yah, the presence of our family, the friends that have come from far, from near. It has been a wonderful occasion, the fellowship of the people of Light Precious Emunah. And I just want to start here in Hanok, chapter 58, verse 2. Concerning the righteous, the Siddiqa, the elect ones of Yah, for that is us, Yisrael. And Enoch says here, blessed, Baruch, you are highly favored. Yahweh has shined upon you. Oh, you righteous, you Siddiq, we are made righteous by the dawn of Yahshua HaMashiach. You righteous and you elect ones. We are elect because Yahweh has chosen us. Because Yahweh has picked us out from before the foundations of the world. He says here, for splendor, the excellence of Yahweh, his kingdom, is your portion. And that is our portion today, Israel. That is our inheritance, as Akiwasadak has brought out to us on this feast. 58 and 3 says, the righteous ones, that is us, we shall be where? In the light of the sun, of Yahshua HaMashiach.
Hallelujah.
For even as on this feast it has been cloudy, it has been rainy, the weather has been somewhat dreary, but still, I don't know about you, but I have been in the light. I have been in the light with my Akim, with my Hokim, in the fellowship of Yahshua. And the elect one shall be in the light of eternal, everlasting, never-ending life, which has no end. And the days of the life of the Kodesh ones, and we are set apart, not because of what we have done, but simply because Yah has set us apart. We have been no more greater than any other people. Yahweh says we were least of any people. But he has set us apart. And our days cannot be numbered. For when this life ends, life is only beginning for us, Yisrael. He says, they shall seek light. I seek light today, Yisrael. Even in this dark, corrupt world where there is no light, I seek the light. We should all seek the light, the Torah, Yahshua HaMashiach. And they find Siddiq, righteousness, with Yahweh of hosts. Shalom be to the righteous. Shalom be to you all, Yisrael. In the shalom of the eternal Yahweh. When Yahweh gives us shalom, can't any man take it from us? As the song of the Oka just would say, this joy that I have, the world cannot take it from me. This light that we have, the world cannot take it from us. No matter how dark it is around us, we still have the light. If we walk in the Torah of Yah. And he says, after this, it shall be told to the Kodesh ones in the Shemayim that they should scrutinize the mysteries of righteousness, that they should scrutinize the gift that Yahweh gives to us all, the gift of Emunah. For it is a mystery that yet not seeing, yet we can still believe.
Hallelujah.
If we are willing and obedient, we will operate in the Emunah of Yahweh. For that is his gift unto us that comforts us, that gives us shalom. For the sun has shined, Yahshua has shined upon the earth, upon the Olam, upon these earthen vessels. He has shined on us today, Yisrael. He has shined on us even from before we came from our mother's womb. And the darkness, he says, the darkness, it is over. We don't have to dwell in darkness anymore, Yisrael. For Yahshua has shined in each and every one of our lives. And he has opened up our eyes. Enoch 58:6 says, there shall be a light that has no end. And they shall not have to count the days anymore. For our days are numbered with Yah, Yisrael. He knows even every hair that is on our head. We don't have to worry or be afraid of anything as we leave from here. We can rest assured as we walk in the light of the Torah, as he guides our every footstep. We can depend on him. For already, it says here, darkness has been destroyed. Because Yahweh destroyed the darkness when he said at the beginning, let there be light. Darkness was destroyed from the Olam, from the face of the deep. And light shall be permanent. There should be no end to the brightness of the splendor before Yahweh of hosts. And the light of uprightness shall stand firm forever and ever before Yahweh. So let us walk in the light, Yisrael. And I'll go here to Hebrews 12:1. It says, wherefore, seeing we are also compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, as we explored Moshe, Yaakov, the acts of Emunah in Hebrews on last evening. We've seen how they performed in the Emunah of Yah. They were not afraid of death. They were not afraid of trials and of tribulations. They are our witnesses, Yisrael. They have moved on. They have passed from this life unto the eternal life. And they see us now as we fight this same fight that they fought. They are our witnesses. Let us lay aside, let us cast off every weight, everything that weighs us down, Yisrael, every sin, every doubt, every worry. Let us cast that to the side, Yisrael. And let us run with patience, with assurance in Yah's Torah, with steadfastness in the Emunah of Yah. Let us run with patience this race that is set before us. And as we run, we may get weary, but when you get tired, just do this, as it says in verse 2 of Hebrews 12. Look to Yahshua. Look to Yahshua. Look to him, Yisrael. Through your trials, when your body is sick, it's hurting, when you feel like you may be all alone, look to Yahshua, for he is the author. He is the one that has wrote the script. He has began this, and he is also the finisher of our emunah. So let us look to him, Yisrael, who for the joy that was set before him, he did it for us. It was his pleasure to suffer for us. It was his joy to hang upon that stake, to be beaten, for his blood, his dam to drip down. It was his pleasure, his joy to do that for us. The joy that was set before him, he endured the stake. He despised the shame. He had no thought, no concern of what the people thought of him, because he knew his purpose was to give unto us eternal life. And because he endured, because he did not despise the chastening, the correction of Yah, it says here he has sat down at the right hand of the throne of Yahweh. And in the day that we overcome Yisrael, we shall sit at his feet. If we keep the emunah, if we fight this fight with patience, we will be at the feet of Yahshua HaMashiach. It says, for consider him. When you are weary, when you are faint, consider him. Think on him that endured such contradiction of sinners against himself. And when we think of the way he suffered, the way he went through and overcame, then we will not be weary and we will not faint in our minds. And in my last verses here, Yisrael, we see in 2 Timothy, chapter 4, verses 6 through 8, that Saul spoke to Timothy as a son. He said, for I am now ready. My mind is made up. My course has been ran. I have done all that I could do. It is time now for Yah to take over. I have trusted. I've walked in the emunah. I haven't wavered. Even when I was weak, I didn't faint. I didn't turn my back on Yah. He said, for I am now ready to be offered. And the time of my departure, it is at hand. It is now. And we all must depart. We all must leave this life. You know, sometimes I think of death. I think of my Akim, that we stand together. And I know that one of us will be next. One of us will be first. And at times, you know, my heart, it brings tears to my lips because I do not want to be without any of my Akim, any of my Hokim. But it is the way of Yah that we must depart, Yisrael. But when I depart, when my Akim depart, when any of us depart, Yisrael, from this life, we should have this testimony here. He says, for I have fought a tough fight. That should be our desire, Yisrael, that we fight a tough fight, that we not back down in the midst of the battle, but that we stand strong and stand firm. He says, I have finished my course. Everything that Yah has intended for me to do, I have done it with all my strength, with all my might, with all that lies within me. He says, I have kept. I have kept. I have kept. I haven't given up. I haven't become discouraged. I haven't ran like a coward. But I have kept the faith. I have kept this emunah that Yah has given to me in his Torah through Yahshua. And when we keep the faith, Yisrael, when we don't give up, there's a reward for us. It says, henceforth, there is laid up for me. I want that testimony when I pass Israel. A crown of Tzedekah, which Yahweh, the righteous judge, he's not going to give you this crown if you don't deserve it. Many are going to seek this crown, Yisrael, but they're not going to receive it because they don't deserve it. Only those who finish the course, who keep the faith, who run with patience this race that is set before us, only we shall receive the crown, Yisrael. He says, Yahweh, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not only to me, not only to Akyoshibia, but unto all, each and every one of you, Yisrael, if you fight the fight, stay the course, keep the emunah, you will receive your crown as well, Yisrael. And unto all them that Ahava, his appearing. So let us, Yisrael, fight the fight. Let us keep the emunah. Don't be discouraged. Don't waver. For what Yahweh has said, it shall come to pass. And if we love his appearing, look for him. When you wake up in the morning, look for him. When you go to bed at night, look for him. In the middle of the day, look for him. Have a hava in his Torah. Have a hava for your hope, your ark. And you shall in no wise lose your reward. You shall receive the crown of righteousness. Hallelujah. Ark Shimri.
Hallelujah. And as we've heard, condition of y'all, we must continue. We must continue as a people. That's the only way that we're going to make it. We must continue. We must stand strong. And we know that once we leave this place, once we begin to journey back to our humble abodes, we hit the highways, and we go back and face the obstacles of this world, we know what we're up against. And the only way that we're going to continue, the only way that we're going to stand is in Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. That's the only way, Kedushims. And as Zakane was saying that, as we begin to leave and go our separate ways, of course, it's only been a few days, but still, we here at Teshua, because we look forward to this every year, to invite the people of Yah, to invite them into our place of refuge, a place that Yah has established through the man of Yah. And as you all begin to leave, of course we feel that. But we know we have to do what Yah's will is. So we must continue within his will to get back on the course of Almighty Yah with our lives. But we must stand strong, condition of Yah. We must stand strong. But we feel it here at Teshua, because this is our home. And we welcome you all back next year. Hallelujah. So let us continue as we leave, as we come to the end of this feast. Hallelujah. And I have a few scriptures here. Psalms 15, 1 and 2. Just something to encourage your heart that we stand as a people. Hallelujah. It says, who shall abide? It's only those that stand and keep the things of Yah true to their heart, those that stay upon their knees, those that are truly sincere, hallelujah, those that continue in this walk and continue to fight the fight of emunah, hallelujah. Yes. Psalms 15 and 1, it says, Yahweh, who shall abide in thy tabernacle? Who shall dwell in thy Kodesh hill? And it says here, it says, he that walketh, he that continue uprightly and worketh Kodeshness. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And worketh Kodeshness and speak the truth within his lab. Speak the truth about yourself. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Identify your ways that we may grow in Yah, that we may continue in this walk. Because that's the only way we're going to make it. We have to see ourselves. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's what Yah intends for his people. We must see ourselves. That's the only way we're going to be able to continue within this walk of this of Yah. Hallelujah. Who shall abide? But we, the people of Yah, those of you that are listening, those of you that are sincere, that is sincere with Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. Who shall abide? Psalms 11. I'm going to Psalms 11. 1-7. Something that may encourage your heart condition. Stand strong. It says, in Yahweh, I put my trust. We must trust in Yah. It says, in Yahweh, I put my trust. How say ye to my soul, flee as a bird to your mountain? For lo, the wicked, they've been there, Bo. So they're out there waiting. Your kinfolks, your children, hallelujah. The court systems, the unsaved wives, the unsaved husbands. Satan is going to do what he can do to make you throw in the towel, to make you give up. Hallelujah. It says, for lo, the wicked bend their bow. They make ready their arrow upon the string, that they may privately shoot at the upright in love. Hallelujah. So we're going to be tried. That's how we know we're in this walk. So let us stand strong, Kedush of Yah. Let us stay upon our knees. Let us pray. Let us walk this walk. Hallelujah. There's nothing else that compare to it. We've heard of the treasures of the riches that Almighty Yah has for us. Hallelujah. Going on down to verse 3, it said, if the fountains be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Yahweh is his Kodesh temple. Yahweh's throne is in the Shemayams. His eyes behold his eyelids. Try the children of men. And it says, Yahweh tried the Kodesh, the righteous, but the wicked and him that love violence, his soul hateth. So Yahweh is the one that allows us to be tried. Hallelujah. He allows it to see what we're going to do. Whether we're going to renege or whether we're going to do what his book says. Whether we're going to do Kodesh. Hallelujah. So Yahweh allows it. He wants us to grow. He wants us to lean more upon him and upon what our mindset tells us to do. Hallelujah. He wants us to put it all in his hands. He wants us to lean on him, regardless of what it is, regardless of what the circumstance is. Yahweh wants us to lean upon him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, Yahweh tried the righteous, the Kodesh, but the wicked and him that loveth violence, his soul hateth. Upon the wicked, he shall rain snares, fire and brimstones, and a horrible tempest. This shall be the portion of their cup. For the Kodesh, Yahweh loveth. Do we hear that? Yes. It say, for the Kodesh, Yahweh loveth. He loveth the righteous. His countenance doth behold the upright. So let us stand upright, Kedush of Yah. Let us walk upright. It say, for Yahweh, he ahav us, those that strive, those that put all that they have within serving Yah. They keep Yah first within their lives. Hallelujah. That's the only way we're going to stand and continue in this way, Kedush of Yah. That's the only way. And how shall we stand? How can we stand? I'm going to read it here in Proverbs 7, 1-3. How shall we stand as a people of Yah? There's no other way but in Almighty Yah. There's no other way, Kedush of Yah. We can think there's some other way that we can slide in, but there's no other way. It's not going to work any other way. Proverbs 7, chapter 7, I'm sorry. My son, keep my words. Do we hear that? We keep the words of Yah. It says, lay up my commandments with thee. keep my commandments and live, and my law as the apple of thine eye. That's the only way we're going to be able to do it. We must stay within this book, condition of Yah. We must allow this book to become our number one, that we may serve Yah with all. That's the only way we're going to make it. That's the only way. That's the only way we're going to make it. It should be as the apple of our eye. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Turn with me in my closing. Psalm 16, 7 through 11. Even in death, conditions of Yah. That's powerful. Even in death, he stands with us. He keeps us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
O death, where is thy sting? Hallelujah. That's what the book says. Psalm 16, 7 through 11. This is what Yah does for his people. Those that continue in the way, those that strive to walk upright. It says, I will bless Yahweh who have given me counsel. My reins also instruct me in the night season. So when Yah gives us counsel, those reins that they have on the side of the horses, it keeps that horse guided straight. It keeps him in the path. It says, I'm going to read again, say, I will bless Yahweh who have given me counsel. My reins also instruct me in the night season. When things are going tough. Hallelujah. When you have no shoulder to cry on. When you feel all alone. It says those reins, they keep you. The reins of Almighty Yah. The getting upon our knees. Hallelujah. The crying, the tears. Hallelujah. Striving for that sincere love towards Almighty Yah. Let me go on and read here in 8. It says, and I have set Yahweh always before me, because he is my right hand. I shall not be moved. If Yah is our right hand, condition of Yah, regardless of where we go, where we are, we shall not be moved. We shall stand. Hallelujah. You can't move this word. This word is going to do what it says it's going to do. Hallelujah. It's going to do it. But we must trust in it. We must trust in Almighty Yah. We must stand upon this word. Hallelujah. We must stand as a people. It says, and shall not be moved. On to 9. It says, therefore my heart is glad, and my honor rejoiceth. My flesh shall rest in hope. Do we hear that? My flesh shall rest in hope. On to 10, verse 10, Psalm 16 and 10, it says, for thou would not leave my nephesh in the grave, even in death, conditions of Yah. Even in death. It says, neither would thou suffer thine Kodesh one to see corruption. Do we hear that, condition of Yah? This is how we continue. We continue in his word. We continue in his emunah. Hallelujah. It says, thou wilt show me the path of life. And this is not life I hear today, but this book is life. This book is life even in death. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, in thy presence is fullness of joy. And at thy right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Hallelujah. Forevermore, conditions of Yah. Forevermore. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even in death, conditions of Yah. So let us stand. Yes, we're going to be tried. Hallelujah. But let us keep in contact. Order our conversations are right, calling one another. Let us begin now to prepare for next year. Because every year it gets better and better. Hallelujah. And so we told you all that have joined us here at Teshua, those of you who had listened on the live stream, and all of you that have come from near and far to be here with us at Teshua Community. Hallelujah. So let us continue in the ways of Yah. Hallelujah. Let us give Yahweh a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Zakenya Romeo. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Well, as we heard from our King Israel, you can sense in their voices and the repetition of the words, Israel, to stand upon Torah. You know, Yahweh, he's an Abba that continues to remind. He repeats himself over and over again. Our lives of repeating over. When you wake up, you go to sleep at night, you wake up in the morning. And it's a repeating process. When you eat something, for surety, it's going to end up in the stool. If you throw something up in the air, it's going to come down. It's just the law of Yahweh. And there's cycles to everything. And just as it is with the feast days, Yisrael. So if we understand and we know that at this time, the feast will begin next year. You don't want to wait up until a few weeks before then or beforehand. Even here at Teshua, we start now. After these feasts, we start right then. And even at that preparation, it seemed like as you knock this out, you finish this, it seemed like there's always a little something that still has to be in preparation, just what's not ready yet. So even at that, we look at our lives. It's a continual cycle. There's always, and there always will be times, we have to make preparation. We have to make ourselves ready. We have to make our minds ready. Our hearts have to be ready at all times. If you're going for a job interview, you don't just prepare the day before. When you go apply that job, before you go apply for that job, you're already trying to prepare, make yourself ready. You get a little nervous. You waiting for that one phone call. Why? Because you need financial aid. You need finance. You need help. You need that job. You have those that take classes, how to present themselves, even how to dress, how to walk. How to keep that constant eye contact. They look at all that when you go for a job interview. That's just not hiring. We go for a job interview. They just don't hire anyone. You go in there, you got a little skip, and your pants hanging off your butt. They look for all that. So there's always a way that you have to present yourself before that employer. So it is as we present ourselves unto Almighty Yahweh. He's not going to accept anything, Israel. He's not going to accept us in the Melkut in his kingdom just any kind of way. He gives us protocol in his Torah. And he gives us apt time to prepare ourselves, to make ourselves ready. We know on the Shabbat, it's on the seventh day. There's always a cycle. When he commands us 6 days, we do labor, and on the seventh day, you rest. So even in that labor, he gives us time, 6 days, to prepare for that time of rest. And if you're not careful, you'll find yourself, if you're not watchful, bringing things into the Shabbat where it should not be so, Yisrael. So he gives us time. He gives us time right now to prepare. To make ourselves ready, to search our lives, to search our hearts, to put back that dollar to here and dollar to there, and to make those necessary preparations, Yisrael. I do want to read something unto us as we begin to bring this to a close. If you recall, I did read in Amos concerning Yahweh continually making a statement, and they return not. Even as he reprove us, he continually remind us time after time again. As he has brought us out of darkness into the light of Yahshua HaMashiach, and just as Torah, just as Yisrael, we find a way to return to those things. He had to bring us out, Yisrael. But it exclaims here also in Hosea. Hallelujah. Hosea chapter 4. He says, hear the word of Almighty Yahweh, O children of Yisrael, For Yahweh hath a controversy, he's against the inhabitants of the land. Why is he against the inhabitants of the land? Are we not inhabitants of the land? Is he talking about a certain people? Sure he is. He said he's against the inhabitants of the land. Why? He said, because there is no truth. He said, because there's no truth. There's no judgment. There's no righteousness. He says, I'm against you. I'm against you because there is no truth. Nor is there hasid, just the tenderness of love and kindness to be patient and to be loving one to another. He said, nor knowledge of Almighty Yahweh and the land. He said in verse 2 that by swearing and lying and killing, stealing, and committing adultery, they break out and blood touches blood. That's what iniquity does, Israel. It adds sin upon sin. The Torah even said, woe unto that one that adds sin upon sin. Iniquity upon iniquity, Israel. We cannot continue in those ways that displease Yah. He says in verse 3, because of that, therefore, shall the land mourn, and everyone that dwelleth therein, they shall languish. Can you tell when someone is famished? When one is languished, he's in need of nourishment. You can tell when one is eating healthy and when one is not. Those of us that have experience in the world, you can tell when one is on drugs and when they're drinking too much liquor. Why? Because their bodies show signs of needing nourishment. They're skinny. Their skin is tight and look elastic. They don't look clean. You can tell when one is famished. You can see that, Israel, and with the physical features. It said, everyone dwelleth therein, they shall languish with the beasts of the field and with the fowls of Hashemayim. He said, yea, even the fish of the sea also will be taken away. Verse 4. Yet let no man strive nor reprove one another, for thy people are as they that strive with the priests. Therefore shalt thou fall in the day, and the Nabi the prophet also shall fall with thee in the night. And we will destroy thy mother. Verse 6. He said that my people, they are destroyed. Can't you see the destruction? Even the mother, the ima, that one that brings forth life. Don't you know, even you that have not bear children and you that have bear children, still the responsibility of the ima is still necessary. Why? Because you bring forth life. You bring forth life in your visions, how you present yourself, that one visually see that you are a pattern for the children and those that desire to have husbands. You must be that, Israel. But he said, even in the night, the prophet faileth, and even the mother is destroyed. He said in verse 6 that my people, they are destroyed because of this, for the lack of knowledge. We have no excuse. We're without excuse tonight, Israel. Because even through these past days, we have been given plenty of knowledge and understanding. We have Zakein, and we have elders here that can teach us young ones, the young ones, how they should walk. We have young men that have wisdom and understanding. Did they not present that to you, through themselves tonight, Israel? And through this feast of wisdom? So why are we continually destroyed? Seeing that Yahweh has provided these things amongst the house of Israel, we must search our Levin, we must search our left. He said, for my people that are destroyed for a lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected. There it is right there. Because we reject. We don't want someone to tell us the truth and to be honest with us. We don't want someone to say, that is not right before Almighty Yahweh. You should not do that. Stop your foolishness. Become sober and serious. Oh, you need to stop that. That's not right to do. We represent the men of Almighty Yahweh, the warriors of Yah. So we have to carry ourselves in a certain way. We must dress a certain way. We must act a certain way. We don't want to hear those kind of things. Critiquing is always for another person, but not for me. Well, critique me, Almighty Yahweh. Show me. Reprove me that I may walk in the way of Siddiq of righteousness. It says, because you have rejected knowledge. He said, I will also reject thee. I don't want y'all to reject me. Once Yahweh shuts the door, Yisrael, you can play around all you want to. Once he had warned us and continued to warn us over and over again, and he shuts that door, no man can open it. Once he takes his hand off of a person, the only thing left for that individual is destruction, Yisrael. Why? Because he continued to warn us over and over again. He said, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt not have a Nabi before you or before me, seeing that thou hast forgotten my Torah, saith Almighty Yahweh. He says, I will also forget your children. We don't want Yahweh to forget our children. Come on, look at the babies here. Come on, we were all once babes, children. We're all once in that same state. And we have to look at them and understand that that is, if I may use the term generation, that is the next generation right there. We don't want Yahweh to forget our little ones, Yisrael, y'all. Because they will carry this message. They will carry this understanding, this wisdom, this fire on. Even as we pass, we have elders in here, old ones. Our Ema, she's over 80 years old. As our Aunt Yoshibi, there's just a time when your time comes that we just have to submit to that. But we don't want Yahweh to forget our little ones. We don't want to do things that cause our little ones to be put in a position that they forget Almighty Yahweh, Yisrael. This is a serious thing. This is a serious thing. Just as Rayat, he inputs into the Akim here, the youth that are listening by via live stream, those he send the emails and messages to. The Zakain that takes their time to instruct. We must hear. We must listen, Yisrael. Hallelujah. We must do that. Let me read this here also in Hosea chapter 7. Well, Yahweh even instructs and he speaks unto us, Yisrael, specifically. You know, we don't mind when someone uses the shotgun effect because we feel like there is a little leeway there to kind of escape. Well, maybe, I know he's talking to me, but maybe he's hitting at someone else. Well, Yahweh doesn't use the shotgun method. He talks directly to you. He looks you right in the eye, Yisrael. So he says this in Hosea chapter 7. He says, when I would have healed, or made Israel complete, then the iniquity of Ephraim was discovered. And it says, the wickedness of Samaria, for they commit falsehood, and the thief cometh in, and the troop of robbers they spoileth without. See, we cannot allow or open the door just to anything, Israel. We cannot open our hearts to accept anything. You know, there's so many messages and doctrines that are out there. Even if you take heed or you listen to those things and you go from one message to another, and even when it doesn't line up with Torah, you know it's not true. What you will find yourself starting to accept a little doubt here. Well, maybe, you know, maybe it's not just that way I've learned. Maybe it's this way. Maybe it's that way. There's people that are so twisted that they're not able to sit amongst a Zakein of truth and hear the Torah because they've been taken by so many winds of doctrine, Yisrael. There's only one truth. There's only one way. If you find life and you're being fed in one aspect, then why should we have to go out and search for any other, Yisrael? Why? What's the purpose? Hallelujah. You know, I look at our cats here, if I may use that for an example. And one thing about a cat, once you feed a cat, you're more or less stuck with it. It knows that you're going to maybe the next day bring it a little something that it can eat. And it will continue to come. And it will continue to come. And it will not go anywhere else as long as you're feeding it. Yahweh, he's feeding us truth, Israel. And you know it's truth when you hear it. So when we hear truth and we receive truth, what's the next process? We must obey. And in that obedience, we do. We do what Torah speaks unto us. It says, and they considered not their own lives, that I remember all of their wickedness. We think Yahweh forgets. Once I came, my sins have been washed under the dam of Yahshua HaMashiach. But yet he remembers. If you transgress the Mishpat, especially when you do it openly and willingly, Israel, you're not going to escape. You're not going to escape, especially when the truth has been revealed to you. He said, I will remember all of their wickedness. And he says, I know their own doings have beset them about. It's your own doings that besets you about. It's our own doing that caused us to veer from the path that Yahweh has ordained. Not my mother. It's not my mother, not my sister, but it's me, oh Yah, standing in the need of prayer. Not my ox, not my hope, but it's me, oh Yah, standing in the need of prayer. Torah says it's your own doings. You're not going to be able to lay this on anyone else, Israel. Your sin and the iniquity that you do that transgress the Torah, the truth of Almighty Yahweh, you cannot blame that on anyone else. Well, my husband made me do it. My children made me do it. No, he said it is your own doings that have beset them about. It says they are before my face. Yahweh said, I see all things. I know all things. It said, they maketh the king glad with their wickedness. What king? What king are we pleasing? Is it Almighty Yahweh of Hashemiah? Or is it our own self-will and our own self-preservation, Yisrael? We're going to be ruled by something or someone. He said, they have made their kings glad with their own wickedness and their princes with their lies. So it says they are all idolaters. As an oven heated by the baker, who ceaseth from rising after he had kneaded the dough until it be leavened. He said, in the day of our king and princesses, have him sick with bottles of wine. He said, have the baker have this one drunk, where he cannot even discern the time when it is ready. He said, he stretcheth out his hand with the scorners. Verse 6. For they have made ready their lamb like an oven, while they lie and wait. He says that their baker sleepeth all the night long. He forget about his responsibility. He forget about what was left there in that oven. That's what sin does, Yisrael. It causes one to forget their responsibilities. It causes one to lose track of the time. He goes on and says that baker, they made him drunk with the wine. He slept all the night. And in the morning, it says that it burneth and as a flame of fire. Have we lost focus, Yisrael? Have we left off the responsibilities that Almighty Yahweh has charged us with? When that baker, when he goes back to that, they made him drunk with the wine. He was not able to zakah to remember the statues and the time. We must understand the time that we're in, Yisrael. And Torah says, when that baker, when he went back to his duty or his works that he left that morning, the Torah says it burned. It has burned, and it was as a flame of fire. And look what Yahweh, he expresses us as a people, as a nation. In verse 7. Torah says that they are all hot as an oven, and they have devoured their judges, and all of their kings are falling, and there is none among them that calleth unto me. He said their leaders, their instructors, those ones that they look upon for strength, the Torah says there were none that could be found. None that could be found. Even after all that destruction, those things that were laid to waste, Israel, Yah said, even after all that, he said, no one returned unto me. Verse 8, he said, Ephraim, he hath mixed himself among the people. Do we find ourselves mixing among the people? We hear, we try to be like them, look like them. We don't want to be set apart. We want to look just like the world looks. We don't want to look odd. We should desire to be different, Israel, y'all. We are different. We are called of Almighty Yahweh. We are called of Yah to walk in his mitzvah and to walk in his Torah. We shouldn't desire the things or to be like the world. Say, Ephraim, he had mixed himself among the people. He said that his cake is not turned. Stranger had devoured his strength, and he knoweth it not. He said he doesn't even know that those that he has mixed himself among, we mix among the world, Israel, y'all, they're going to take our strength. They're going to take your testimony. They're going to drain your emunah if you mix yourself with the world, Israel. He said, and he knoweth it not. Yea, he said, gray hairs are here and there even upon him, yet he knoweth it not. It says this in verse 10. This is a tragedy here. It says, and the pride of Israel testifieth to his face. Have pride blinded our eyes, Israel? We don't want one to speak the truth. We don't want one to tell us. We become drunk with the things of the world that we forget Yahweh. We forget his mitzvah. We forget his Torah. It says that even the pride of Israel testifieth to his face, and they do not return unto Almighty Yahweh there abide. We must return unto Yah, Israel. We must return unto Almighty Yahweh, for he is our strength. So even as we go back, as we hear occulting, it's just not you all that have visited. It's us too. We go back to work. We go back amongst the laboring world. We have to watch ourselves. We have to be careful not to have the desire to mix with the world that we forget Yah. We allow it to make us drunk, that we forget our responsibilities. And behold, before you even realize it, time has gone by that you don't even see. You can't even visualize what has taken place until it's too late. That's why we shouldn't mingle with the world, Israel. We shouldn't desire the things of the world. It says, verse 9, that he had gray hairs even upon him, yet he knoweth it not. It says that his pride, in verse 10, testifieth to his face. And they do not return unto Yahweh their Abba, nor even seek him for all of this. So we must seek Yah, Yisrael. Even as we return to doing our daily tasks, to somewhat get back into the scheme of things, let us not forget Almighty Yahweh. Let us not forget our whole King. You know, even as our King, as we sit and we talk and I listen, I hear the testimonies of deliverance and wisdom, that I'm even able to apply that to my own life to say, okay, I know, all right, I see what that op done there. I want to apply that same principle, that it may uplift me and give me strength in that time of trial or in that time of testing. That's what we should do, Israel. Each and every one of us should be able to take something and apply it to our own life, because we have those that live among us with our examples, Israel, to follow. So let us be mindful of even our own selves, of the Torah. Let us not forget all what we have heard and the beautiful fellowship, Israel. I become attached to Israel very easily. In other words, Yaakov, I'm already thinking about the departure. Markos, Yahweh Barakimah, I've told you Yah for you. Those that have been faithful, Shalom. You know who I'm talking to back there, my big brother. See you all leave again, but yet we're still close. We're knitted, our lives are knitted together. And we just Barak and told the Yahweh for all things for this experience. Because it's a beautiful thing to come together to rejoice, to sit. Even when there's not much to say, just the presence of an ox just sitting there. Just it's a fulfilling thing. It's very fulfilling. So I echo the same thing. We Ahava you all. We Barak you all. We do appreciate y'all coming to celebrate this feast with us. And even as the sun has set, it's dark outside. This is a Shabbat. Yisrael, y'all, let us be mindful of our actions, what we do, that we rest, that we keep our minds upon Yahweh, and that we continue on fighting the tough fight of Emunah. We have heard from our Akim, it is a fight. Don't let no one fool you. But yet Yahshua here has gone on before us. That's what a tough shepherd does. That's what a leader does. He goes before the people. Yahweh said, Yahshua said, I go before you. Did not he go before the state for us? If he did not go before the state, then every one of you, your children, will have to face that state. Everyone will have to face your own sin and the repercussions of that. But Yahshua, he took that state for us. He said, that's all right. He said, I will go before you. And I'm so glad that he did, Yisrael. I'm glad that he did. Hallelujah. Because of him, we are here and we are alive today. Because of here we have Teshuvah, we have victory over sin, Yisrael. Don't allow your emotions to take hold of you when things are pressing, when they seem tight. When you look around you, it seems like the presence of Yahweh has somewhat removed itself. It has not, because he is in you, my aunt. He is in your hopes. So let us stand on truth. Let us stand on Emunah. Because when all else fails, the Torah, it never fails. Yahshua never fails. Hallelujah. He said he is always with us. He said he doesn't leave us. We are his kedusha. We are tzaddik. We are righteous. He has deemed us to be righteous even in this hour, Yisrael. So let us not depart from the truth. Let us stand. Let us fight. Let us endure that we may see what the end of all this thing shall be. I want to see what the end of this thing, whether it's the end of my life, I want to come to the end of that. And as our ox said, you can look back and know without a shadow of doubt that you have fought this fight faithfully and you have endured for Yahshua HaMashiach because he has endured all things for us. So Yahweh Barak you all, we know that Yahweh, he gives his beloved rest. He gives his beloved sleep. Shalom there. Hallelujah. Praise Yahweh. Yes. Hallelujah. So let us stand to our feet, Yisrael. It has been a wonderful time, wonderful occasion, the fellowship. Let us shoot, let us turn. Because even though we are in this world seeming of captivity, yet we are made free. Not only we set, you know, you have those that said, Yah sets us free. He makes us. He renews us. Hallelujah. He makes us free. Almighty Yahweh, we do total you for this time, this occasion, this Yom. We have gathered even at this time, this eve, Abba Yahweh, to honor you, to obey your statutes, to walk according to your Mishvah and your Torah. And you said, Abba Yahweh, if one will obey and submit and walk according to your statutes, then you will open the women of Hashemayim, and that you will pour out upon them a blessing that they would not even be able to receive even the full contents of it, Abba Yahweh. So we told you for Yahshua. We told you for life. We told you for the deliverance. We told you, Abba Yahweh, for washing us for all of our sins. Hallelujah. We told you, Abba Yahweh, was able to make it to this place. Those that are listening by via a live stream were able to listen and be there with us. We just Barak you, Abba Yahweh, for all things. And for everything. For everything. For everything. In the precious and wonderful name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do pray. Hallelujah. 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 Yahweh Barak you, Yisrael. Hallelujah.